Now, yeah. Now the question comes, you passed the polytechnic and job or higher studies? How did that come to?
The higher studies was, I was literally interested, but again, I know the family situation. Again, I can't say that waste, but I can spend more years for the studies. Mm-hmm. I realized that I have to work more. So after my diploma, was searched many times, jobs. Actually, after diploma, searched jobs and I didn't get, again, I started working. So my neighbor, cousin brother was there. So his workshop. So I started work with him. So when after 3 years, I got per day 150 rupees. That was my daily wages with him. So he's my cousin brother. So he know my family situation. So he gave that money actually. Mm-hmm. So I worked for 2 or 2.5 months. Mm-hmm. That time I got interview for apprenticeship training in Instrumentation Limited, Palakkad. Mm-hmm. So Instrumentation Limited is a central government organization. They're arranging apprenticeship for diploma holders. So I attended the interview. So that my panelists, they asked what now you are doing. So I said, I'm working in workshop. So they also wondered that, yeah. So luckily I got offer from there and I started working in instrumentation for 1 year. So 2010, September to 2011, that was an apprenticeship time. So 2011, September, I got completed. So after 1 year completion, they will not get permanent and there it is not there actually. So I went out after training and then joined again. I started working workshop because I didn't get any job. So during that time, what I did, I have few contacts who is studying in my college, seniors. Mm-hmm. So they had given me few numbers for contracts. Mm-hmm. In Mumbai actually. Mm-hmm. So myself like that ki, I know little bit Hindi, my mom and dad well known Hindi actually. Mm-hmm. They are from childhood I'm much good Hindi was good in actually. So I called the contractors or whoever number shared. I asked them for a job actually. Mm-hmm. So one or two people, they said that you can come Mumbai, then we will do arrange. Mm-hmm. We will arrange. Mm-hmm. So two companies, their owners were okay to take us. So I asked one of my friend Vishnu. Mm-hmm. He is in Pattampi. Mm-hmm. He was in Pattampi. So we both decided that we'll go. So one of my cousin also there in Mumbai, his name is Shivadasan. Mm-hmm. So he arranged accommodation and at their place actually, their home. And we left Kerala in November 2011 for that job. But okay. That job was not, there is no surety of job. He said that you first come and meet us, mm-hmm. then we will arrange. Mm-hmm. So we went to Mumbai and we went to meet that officers. They were running contracts in HPCL refinery, Hindustan Petroleum Refinery, Chembur actually. Mm-hmm. They are Malayali, they are from Thrissur only. So that communication was very okay with that. And they said that, okay, you joined as an instrument fitter. Mm. Our technician job and it was a very small salary they offered actually, but it was okay. At least we can start in the same field or maybe get good job, good offers for that. So we joined and we started staying in, it's a slum area actually, Govanpada. I still remember it is like that chal and everything which we can see in films actually. Mm. That was so in two rooms were there, so total we 7 or 8 people were there actually. So they provided the accommodation and that, we used to cook there. So that was for almost 2.5 months and I was worked there. So between that, one of my cousin, he's in Reliance only. He's working in Reliance. So I have given my resume to him. Luckily, I got an interview from Reliance actually. So as you asked, I was literally not aware of both. I was not fluent in English and Hindi till that time. And that was my first interview with a good company. I just went there. So my shirt was open and I was with my chappals actually. So I meet one of, I mean, he's very good and he's like my own brother now, Mr. Sharad. He said, hey, bro, how you come like for interview in Reliance? You have to in your shirts and you should not be with chappal and all. He guided me. But luckily, I was attended that interview. There was aptitude test, general test, everything was there. And they called interview. I mean, almost 8 or 10 candidates were there. And they called me for first, actually, for interview. I mean, the walk-in. And I went there. I had interview within just 10 minutes. So when I was in apprenticeship, I used to work in plant also. Basically, for instrument, I mean, diploma holders, they give the job profile for the documentation purpose. But I know many things from assembly, like in factory place, I learned very much. I have many documents from there. So I know the technical things from related to valve manufacturing now. So they asked me everything. So I answered. Just 10 minutes, I have done my interview. And I came out. And rest all are from Mumbai, who completed engineering, who completed diploma, well-known Hindi and well-known English. Yeah, so like still I know that I'm not much fluent in English, but I can manage. I'm handling meetings, I'm handling the conferences and trainings, everything. So that was first time I struggled to speak English, I struggled to speak Hindi actually. Then luckily I got job, and same job I joined as a consultant for in Reliance, and I placed in Gujarat. Yeah, so 2012 February, I went to Gujarat and joined. I was worked almost 3 years, 2000 till 2015, I worked there as a consultant. I was not permanent there because of I was not graduate actually. So, but that 3 years, like anything, where I started speaking English, started attending training, started attending meeting, and Reliance was the, I mean, Reliance given me a good exposure to grow actually. And luckily my leaders, like my reporting officers, very supportive actually. And that 3 years I was worked like anything, no time, nothing, that I was worked hard actually. That I know, I remembering
how
that.
How many hours you used to work?
It was like, it's a 24-hour running plant. So our office time was like 8:30 to 5:30 only, but definitely most of the time it will get delayed due to some technical issue or some problems in plant. And sometimes I used to go by night during night times and all. So that way I worked 3 years, and between that my boss was absent, my leader was absent for a few months, and I was handled the plant operation with support of other colleagues. And that time I learned I learned many things, to handle independently the plant and other things. So it gave me a good experience that time, and I got a good confidence in my job that I can do those jobs independently, I can learn. So that was a turning point in my life. That I started learning, I started working. I feel very good that 3 years actually. So after 3 years, still I was not confirmed, and that is 2015. So during that time, even I was also searching for many jobs, even abroad. And I mean, I didn't get any good offer or opportunity. That time only I attended interview for Mahanagar Gas. Mumbai. It was again the same gas pipeline company, and luckily I got a job as a technician because I was diploma holder. So they designation as like for diplomas, it's technician. So from executive engineer to I joined as a technician. Yeah. So 2 years I was worked. This 3 years I was worked in operations, and there I was in field. I have to take toolbox, I have to go field, I have to work, I have to in that way I have to literally hands-on experience I got from MGL actually, Mahanagar Gas. So again I was in good connection with my ex-boss and all the colleagues. So luckily in 2017 my boss given me again an opportunity to join back. He supported because the person who was there, he left and they need a person. So that time I had almost 5 years experience, and I hope that I worked well there. And so my boss helped me that he also know my background and everything. So he recommended me to get back. So in 2017, I joined as a manager operations in Reliance.
So when did you do this engineering? I think you did converted your diploma to engineering also, right?
No, engineering diploma. This is engineering diploma.
Engineering diploma.
Not graduated yet.
I mean,
2014 or 15, I was tired, but it didn't get complete, yeah. Actually.
Mm-hmm. That's in your goal, I guess. I understand that you want to.
Yes, still.
Okay.
Still,
So you still work in, and you should tell the people are very ambitious to know what you are now. So you're working with Reliance as what?
Yes, I was joined permanent. I mean, it was a dream that I get a permanent job in Reliance because I know the culture, I know the opportunity to learn and grow the professional life. Everything was there. So I was worked 2017 to 2019. So again, between this year, that some happy things happened that I got married. My wife, her name Ajita, and my daughter Arya. So it was, it was a love marriage. We met in Facebook. Okay. Yeah, so luckily our families were agreed, and I got married in 2017. When I joined Reliance, after 6 months, I got married actually. Yeah, so we settled in Gujarat. I was in Gujarat for 2.5 years with my family. And again, now everything was routine, like going for office and coming, the jobs were same. So I thought I should, I should grow. No, this is not the end. Okay, so I have to learn much more. So that time I got opportunity for projects that was for the city gas distribution business. That time even central government also came into bidding authorization to many companies for laying city gas pipeline. In Kerala also two companies are developing the gas pipeline network. So I joined in AGNP in 2019. So main reason to leave Reliance that I got job in Kerala, hometown. Because for engineering people, it's very difficult. Even for oil and gas professionals, getting job in Kerala is very difficult because we don't have much opportunity in Kerala.
Correct.
Very few. So that was a good point that at least I can get settled and I can work in same field. So I joined AGNP. So again, from manager, I joined as assistant manager projects in AGNP because I like to work for projects actually. So we shifted, with my family, I shifted to Trivandrum. So 1 year I have worked, and in this period only I got so two things happened that Mahanagar Gas job which I got offer, it is through Naukri.com. And this job, my present job, which is through LinkedIn.
Okay.
So I'm suggesting my friends that be active in such sites, definitely you will get a opportunity.
Now, yeah, so now where are you based? Are you based in Trivandrum or are you based in Bombay?
No,
which company are working?
Yeah, so now I am with the Ashoka Buildcon Limited.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, Ashoka Buildcon is the civil infra. They are in oil and gas since 2016.
Mm-hmm.
So we are operating city gas in Ratnagiri and Latur and Chitradurga, three places. So I am in Ratnagiri location. It is between Mumbai and Konkan route only. So I joined as a deputy manager operations in this November, actually November 2020 I joined here. So I am looking after operation and maintenance of the Ratnagiri region.
Okay, great.
Yeah,
and, sir. So I think it's a very big story. Actually, you started very small, and you have seen all the thing and you have reached a high level, deputy manager, right?
Deputy manager.
So I was told that, you know, if I have seen you 15 years back, nobody would have thought you would reach this level. So that's why I was very impressed of interviewing you. You know, people who knows close by, I don't want to say the name, he said that boy, only thing he knows about was that he was confident. Okay, he was confident. And he was determined to win. So, is that right?
Yes, sir. Obviously, I was very confident with my job. I actually English is a good. I mean, main thing that, you know, whether once this language got in hand, then we have to handle. And that was a very difficult thing. That, you know, when we comes from Kerala, we have to. Language is a big factor, actually. So I think my confidence increased once I started handling English.
Okay.
I can write mails, I can attend trainings, I can ask questions in trainings.
Okay. So now, I understand. So just to ask, what could, you see, there are a lot of people listening, especially from Kerala, always from villages, from town also. Nowadays, with a lot of people with no opportunities, because COVID has taken many opportunities, you know. So the people are all desperate at your age also, you know, and not only your age, people like in our age also. So what is that success? Because you have come with a lot of struggles in your life. People, it's very easy to say that, you know, I was working and living in my home, mother's salary for 500 rupees, but that was all frustrations. Yes. So how did you manage the frustration? Listen to the question. How did you manage the frustrations? That's the first question. And the second question is, what is your success mantra to the people who are listening, who wants to come up in life?
Okay. I think that struggle, I don't think whenever I was going through those situations, I never feel that it's a struggle. That was part of my life.
Okay.
That was my thinking. I never feel now maybe someone is going, I mean, when I shared the story and people are wishing me and they are excited. I mean, they have wondered how you manage this thing. That time only I'm thinking that I didn't feel it's a struggle actually. That was a phase of life where my family situation was like that. So I know that I have to do those things to help my family, or I have to do this for my family growth and all. So still I can say that I'm not financially well settled, but I'm professionally well settled. I am good experience. I'm not worrying about any job for, you know, in coming years. I know that I have good contacts in the industries. So I'm very much confident in my professional career, my knowledge, my job skills. So I think I didn't feel that it is a struggle way. Whatever thing happened to me, I just faced. That's it.
Was there any incident that people made insult to you? You are so sad, you are hurt. And, you know, nowadays, you know, the people are getting hurt very easily. They just go and do suicidal. Your situation is that easy way, or should have shied away from all the responsibilities and gone somewhere, no? But you fought it.
Definitely. Everything, you know, whatever, maybe people may be there, but no one insulted me in front of me, maybe from backside, I don't know. But I never heard those things. I was not interested to hear those things, actually. I was just went through my
way. You want to
win. Yeah, really. Maybe I have a target that, like, I have to be like, so I didn't feel that I am in a lower place or lower stage. I was very confident in my knowledge and my skills, actually, from my start of my profession, actually. So, yeah, so that success mantra is nothing. I was a hardworking. I am a hardworking person. Still, I am a hardworking person. I used to work from 9 to 9 still. So now I'm concentrating with my leadership skills and all. I joined here, made a good team. Now, you know, when I'm hearing from my colleagues that, sir, you come and made a good team and we are working together, we are also happy. So that happiness is, I'm very happy to hear those things from my colleagues, my subordinates. So hardworking is that. Even now, my subordinates are also now like that key. And till what time I'm sitting inside office, they also will be there with me, actually. No one will, they will no, once I left, then only they will go. That kind of subordinates I got. So I've shown that hard work is always give you good results,
and success. Determination. There is no doubt. Yeah. So, yes. Okay. So thank you, Rajesh, for sharing your success mantra. I really can understand that, that you have come up with a very low profile, you have reached this level and you're getting a handsome salary now. You manage a big team there in Bombay, in Ratnagiri. So it all comes with your sheer determination, with the positive thinking. And I am really happy that I could bring you from my show Dream to Destiny. And I want to tell all my audience that, this gentleman has dreams and he has worked with the dreams. He want to have the dreams to get, get results. And he still have goals. For example, he wants to convert his engineering, diploma to an engineering graduation. And he is willing to learn and to apply that knowledge and improve upon. He never says that, he never thought that, I know everything. Basically, the attitude what I understood from him, he's so far talking is that, I know everything, I'm the best. But he's not like that. He has an open mind to learn and he want to climb up stairs still. And thank you very much, Rajesh. Let God give you all the blessings so that you can reach new heights and help people. Okay.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.